Good morning, gang. Happy Friday morning. So here we are, less than a week away from Title 42 ending, okay? Basically meaning we send illegals back, okay? The Trump era policy to kind of somewhat protect our borders, and Biden's going to stop it, okay? I want to give you some facts on what's going on. Right now, there are 700,000 people waiting at the border to cross over come next Thursday. That's more than the entire population of Nashville, Boston, okay? That's adding an entire major metropolitan city of people in one day. Border Patrol also says there's going to be another 400,000 people coming every month. That's somewhere to the tune of about 13,000 a day. Okay? Start thinking about your neighborhood. Are there 13,000 people in your neighborhood? Your small town, whatever? Probably not. But we're going to add a city the size of your small town every day, starting next week. So how does this affect us? Oh, I don't know. Let's see. We have talks of, what have we been talking about for a couple of years? Inflation. All these more people, which means there's going to be more demand for everything and less supply. Well, we have a problem with that. That causes inflation. What do these people bring to the United States? Basically nothing, okay? Look at Yuma, Arizona. Teeny, tiny little Yuma, Arizona. Yuma, Arizona has $26 million worth of unpaid medical bills from illegals coming across that will never get paid. Oh, until they raise your insurance premiums or raise your co-pays to pay the hospitals off. That's how it'll affect you. How's it going to affect you when you go into the grocery store and there's less food? Because more people have to eat. How's it going to affect you in the grocery store when the food is even more expensive? Because of all the food that was stolen, because they have no money. How's it going to affect you when you walk down the street and somebody desperate for anything pickpockets you, hits you with a bat, sticks a knife in your back, because they want your purse, they want your wallet? How are you going to react? Then we get into the other side of things, okay? You know, you look at Eric Adams up in New York begging Greg Abbott to stop sending illegals up there because, oh, that's the white man trying to put the brown man down. Really? No. You said you're a sanctuary city. Put your money where your mouth is. How about the soon-to-be former mayor of Chicago? Saying the same thing. Sorry, no. You're a sanctuary city. Put your money where your mouth is. You add all this influx of people who have nothing, okay? Desperate people do desperate things. These people are desperate. They're willing to break the law to come here, okay? What other laws are they willing to break? If it comes down to feeding themselves, you'll get desperate enough, you'll do anything to feed yourself, okay? If it means stealing, if it means robbing, if it means killing, people do it, okay? But then you add the other side of the fence to this. We take all these liberal, progressive policies of defund the police, not prosecuting people, What happens then? Oh, well, Juan or Maria just broke into a house, killed the little old lady in there, and stole all the money and the food. Yeah, but they were poor, desperate people, so we'll give them a slap on the wrist and release them back into society. And Juan and Maria go, cool, do it again. Okay. This is what's going to happen. Now, the other side is what we're going to do to protect ourselves. If the police aren't there to protect us, what happens? Then you have vigilantism. Okay. Death Wish. Remember that movie? Charles Bronson, not the Bruce Willis makeover. Okay. But what happens then when Juan and Maria break into the little old lady's house and the little old lady pulls out a shotgun and blows them away? Okay. Depending on the state you're in, some states, like Florida, the sheriff will go on the news and say, wish we had more people like that little old lady. Some states will go arrest her for murder. Where do you want to be? Okay. But this is what our government is doing. You know, it's funny because you hear from a lot of, mostly liberals, okay? Oh my God, this country sucks. This country sucks. We've got to change everything. We've got to change everything. You know, we've got to do this different. We've got to do this different. We've got to do this different, right? Progressive, you know, meaning going forward. If this country sucks so bad, why are all these illegals trying to come here illegally? Okay? Because it's better than where they are. What are they leaving? They're leaving socialist, progressive hellholes because this place isn't one yet. I've said many times, the only thing that stands between world chaos and world sanity is the Second Amendment. This is why liberals are so hell-bent on taking our weapons from us. I mean, you got the cackling hen out there the other day calling for an assault weapons ban after a handgun shooting in Atlanta. I guess now they're going to start calling handguns or assault weapons too, okay? You know, so give them time. The butter knife is going to be an assault weapon. It doesn't matter. Anything that you can use, I mean, a rock. Sorry, you know, Mr. Pinball, you're not allowed to have rocks in your backyard anymore. Those are assault rocks. Good, you come clean up Tennessee for me, we'll be all set, okay? I'd be more than happy for you to come clean out the rocks. But this is the insanity that's coming. They're going to open the freaking borders, let in 700,000 people in a day, okay? We sent 1,500 people to process paperwork. Do the math, okay? What? You're going to have each one of those 1,500 people process 4,000 names a day? Yeah, that'll happen, okay? What is that? That's somebody going, I might get through my 4,000 rubber stamping everybody, okay? That's about it. But when the crime picks up, what is our leftist, progressive, communist, socialist government going to do to protect those of us that have a legal right to be here? Anybody else get the idea that the most unwanted person in the United States is a legal citizen? They don't want us to vote. They want the illegals to vote, but they don't want the citizens to vote. They don't want us protected. They want to take everything away from us, our land, our freedoms, our weapons, our food, our money. And they want to let all these other serfs come in. Do you get the idea now? This is not the Reagan era, bring everybody up. This is the typical Democrat/Rhino era of A Race to the Bottom. Pinball out.